So speaking of technology, I want you to take a look at this video clips.
Okay.
It's very short clips, and I want to hear your take on this.
I'm sick and tired of you guys using ChatGPT to respond to my discussion posts. You're supposed to use your brains. How will you ever learn if you just use robots all the time? You're all gonna work for me. You're gonna have no jobs.
That's great. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the teachers is losing it because he got fed up so much with students using AI.
Right.
To help with the work, the assignment, the homework, right?
Yeah.
So the AI is a big thing. Everybody's talking about it. Everybody's trying to make the most use out of it.
Mm.
A lot of people might try to use it to help with their business and everything else, right?
Yeah.
So what is your take on the AI, or ChatGPT or Bard?
It's really quite a game changer for the world. I think that's a great example of you know where it can really cause massive disruption and dislocation in the markets. Again, back to the thing, technology is just a tool, but very, very powerful tool. You can use it for good, you can abuse it as well. I do think that there's a there's a huge opportunity, especially the recent change in ChatGPT, which is called generative AI, which is a new wave. I think it does change quite a lot of things, which is different from before. So if you asked about AI maybe 2 years ago, a lot of people would have said, well, you know what, it will replace some of the jobs which are repetitive kind of jobs, right? The blue collar going to be more affected than the white collar to some extent, you know. But those who are more educated, who are doing creative stuff, those are safe. Those are fine. With the change that came with the generative AI and ChatGPT, you can't say that anymore.
Yeah.
Because the creativity, it used to be the human domain, is now getting disrupted as well. It's very easy to do a lot of things which are typically belong to the creative people and creative economies, creative tasks, now can be done, whether it's videos, whether it's writing essays, poems, songs, movies, all of these things can be easily done by generative AI, and it's getting better. So I think there's a lot of change that came with that. And it means that a lot of people who are better educated now is also impacted. So that's definitely one big change. And that's a scary part of it. But there's also a huge opportunity part that come with this as well. Take that example, like the teachers is frustrated, right? If we have moved to a society where everyone just use ChatGPT to do the essays, that's okay, that's not great, right? That's abusing it and everything.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it can also reshape the way that we do education. So instead of making you know, student kind of write everything, you can help embrace it and say, okay, you can use it, but you have to declare that you use it. I know some teachers who kind of help get ChatGPT to write the answers first and get the student to say, critique it. What's wrong with this? Why is this wrong? Because ChatGPT is not perfect. They get facts wrong. Sometimes they connect the dots which are not really there. A lot of these problems, right? And you change your role. The human changed their roles. The same way that when a calculator came about, you're not going to get students to just, you know, crunch numbers anymore, right? But you're going to change your assignments to one where you have to think about how to ask the right question, right? And same way with ChatGPT, you got to get students to think more about how do you ask the right question, prompt them the right way. Why are they reacting differently when you ask them this way or that way, right? And there's a lot of creative way you can put in to ask ChatGPT. You can say, hey, can you act as my coach? Can you act as my teacher? Can you act as my teacher with bad temper? You can do all these kind of things, right? And then you can do that. And then you become, we had a standard here. The journalism will change. A lot of you, the writers, may become editors as well, and that happens to me some extent. Sometimes I get them to write something for me much quicker. To be honest, I just give them a nice prompt, and then now I have to edit them, and I have to think about what's wrong with this statement. Why is the tone not right? You know, is it a better way to do this?
Yeah,
and I change the role from peer writer to editor. And that's hard as well. But I think that's what's going to happen, is that the role of human will change. You have to embrace the change and use it differently, because it's a lot of opportunities too. you can spend a lot more time doing the fun part of the job, you know, thinking about the big question, how to come up with the cool questions. You can spend time maybe go out a little bit more and interact with the students more. For example, teachers, instead of thinking about all these things, you maybe let's change to kind of verbal, right? Verbal examination. Come and I explain to you based on interview. If you use ChatGPT, you probably cannot answer my questions, right? And that way you actually may get to know your student individually even better. So there's a lot of things you can do. But it's so early that I think right now it feels like just pure disruption. Not a lot of opportunities.
Well, we have to learn to use it as a tool. Don't just look at it as a threat, think. Because if you want to look at things as threat, you everything could be a threat
everything
to you.
And you know, we in some ways we in Thailand we are the taker of this technology, right? Even though we say, oh, maybe we shouldn't think, we should think about how the AI should be developed, right? The guys in the US, in China, all these AI developers, they're not going to listen to us. They're going to do what they do anyway. So we might as well just take it and then ask, how can we utilize it to our best abilities? In fact, for Thailand, it's not such a bad thing because, as we talked about, we have an aging population. We have you know, workers who are, we have lack of workers problem, right? So actually, this can help a lot of productivity. One of the very powerful things that generative AI helps is that this kind of a, what do you call it, no-code world, where you can actually do a lot of use of software without knowing how to code or program, right? And that's great, because in the past, finding a programmer is really hard. Right? If you're SME, it's a small business, you can't get like all the programmers who work for you, right? Hard. But if it becomes so easy over time, then maybe you can do digital marketing, you can do like, you know, social media optimization, you can all these things without having to know how to code. You can, one day you might be able to just not even type it, right? For older people, it might be easier. You can just talk into the mic, like, hey, can you do this for me? And, you know, tell me, you know, where can I find my kids?
คว้าโอกาสล่าอนาคตล้วง insight The Standard Economic Forum 2023 Future Ready Thailand เศรษฐกิจไทยไล่ล่าอนาคตรวมผู้นำระดับโลกและไทยกว่า40คนไว้ในงานเดียวพบกับเศรษฐาทวีสินบรรทุนล่ำซำเศรษฐพุทธสุทธิวาทนฤพุทธสุรเกียรติเสถียรไทยสุปชัยเจียรวนนท์สุภวุฒิสายเชื้อกอบศักดิ์ภูตระกูลพยงศรีวณิชทัตยาอินทรวิชัยสมโพศอาหุไนธนาธรจึงรุ่งเรืองกิจฟาบริซิโอซาโคเน่พบกันวันที่23-25พฤศจิกายน2566จัด3วันเต็มณศูนย์การประชุมแห่งชาติเศรษฐกิจซื้อบัตร Early Bird ราคา 2,500 บาทได้แล้ววันนี้ถึง31ตุลาคมเท่านั้น